Om, may Brahman protect us. May it nourish us. May we work in harmony with great vigor. May our study be illuminating. May we not cherish ill feeling towards each other. Om, peace, peace, peace. Today is the Vivekachudamani, and our verse today is 423, where Shankaracharya describes the quality of a knower of Brahman, a jnani. How does he behave? What is the difference between jnani and ajnani? What is the difference between jivan mukta and baddha jiva? So that's how we have to understand the state we have to reach and where we are. Otherwise, if we do not know the state of one who has realized the truth, what will happen there? What will inspire us to get free from the bondage of samsara? So to that, Shankaracharya tries to describe, if one who has gone beyond the bondage of samsara, how does he feel? How does he live? What is the difference in action and thought from us who are still unrealized soul? So here all this it says. So comparing that, he says, verse 423, Ajnana hridaya granthir vinasho yad aseshatah anichor visaya kimnu pravritte karanam svatah. So the thing, what happens in the case of those who have not realized, or those who are in bondage, the first basis of bondage is ajnana. When we are not aware of our true nature, then other things are built on it that binds us still more. First, ajnana of our true nature, that we are nitya satta buddha mukta, nitya shuddha buddha mukta atma, that is not there. If we don't consider ourselves as the atman and think ourselves as this physical entity, then the problems arise. So when this ajnana happens, what is ajnana gives? When I become limited being, present in this universe, suddenly I face the whole universe. Now one thing is fear comes, fear about my own existence. And other thing is, I feel myself incomplete. I am not full, I am not whole. And as my true nature is infinite and whole, full, purna, so this apurnatva or incompleteness, it bothers me a lot, and I try to become complete. How this desire for fullness comes? Because of ajnana. Ajnana of what? Ajnana of thinking myself as apurnatva. Apurnatva is not there, it's all full, it's all purna. But somehow I become unaware of my real nature and consider myself as a limited being in this vast universe. So desire to make myself full, that comes. When that desire comes, then desire impels us for the action, for the work. We have to do something to achieve that fullness. So this all is based on what? On ajnana, on ignorance of my own nature. This ignorance creates all this problem. When this desire to become full comes, and then the pravritti comes, I want to act, I want to fulfill desire. So what type of desire to become full? Whatever we do in the world is for making myself complete, full, whole. That we call being happy. When we seek happiness, we are in fact seeking the fullness of ourselves. We feel ourselves inadequate, incomplete. Having a simple cloth, I am incomplete. I want expensive cloth. I want nice suit, good tie. This all desire is to make myself full. I feel I am incomplete without that thing. I want a nice ring, expensive pen. I want a big house and nice car and long life and healthy body, handsome body. Like all this is the sense comes from incompleteness. I am not good looking, that sense comes. Then all I have to go to the, all the things, Sephora or what they say, you have to go there. Because I feel myself incomplete. I feel myself not good looking enough, so I have to add something. But that also doesn't help. Because that doing also, I see someone and say, oh, that person is more good looking than myself. So then such type of thing happens when I feel by ignorance I am incomplete, I am not full, I am not good looking enough, I have to add more, my clothes are not that nice looking, people don't see, I want to become popular, attractive, I want to become seen and observed, I want to have the impression upon others, and all this comes from the ignorance that I am not whole, I am not full, I am not infinite, I am not in all. That sense of the Atman is totally lost, this Ajnana comes. In fact is, it is all is my own self that has become everything. There is nothing else that I am not. And that sense is not there. From this Ajnana comes, then comes Ichha. Desire comes from Ajnana. The desire will be there. And with the desire to become full, to become complete, to become whole, all our actions are for that. Good marks, nice job, nice food, visiting places, going to pilgrimage, going for excursion, all this comes from desires are prompted by thinking, I am not there, I am not full. Without that, I am not complete. Incompleteness is there. If I don't get that food, I am not happy. If I don't visit that place, I am not happy. If I don't wear that, I am not happy. If I don't get this nice table, that what you call marble nice table from Rajasthan, then I am not happy. It's so nice I saw in my friend's house. And all desires are prompted when we happen to see. Sometimes it is not there. Sometimes we have a glimpse and some person utilizing and suddenly I want to possess that, forgetting in that person in my own self. I am using it there. If I had that much knowledge, desire will not be there, Ichha will not be there. And what happens with the Ichha this coming? Which Ichha comes? With the Ichha comes pravritti, action. Action for being full, whole, getting something that will make me happy. In the language we say, I will become happy if I get married. I will become happy if I have children, I will become happy if I have grandchildren, and I will become happy if I divorce. Like that, everything is for happiness, for being full. After getting married also, he is not full, because ignorance is there. Ajnana has not gone about oneself. Nothing can make that person happy. So everything is done to become happy in the sense, the person, he or she, is searching to really attain himself or herself, which is infinity, which is whole, which is full, which is purna. This purna is not there. So, ajnana hridaya grantir vinaso yad asesata. If someone said ajnana is destroyed, ignorance is not there, that person knows what real nature is. Ajnana is gone. Jnana has come, awareness has come, that I am Self, I am Atma, nothing there is that doesn't belong to me. All this whole universe is my own Self. No one is alien. Holy Mother is saying, feel, try to make all your own. No one is a stranger, my child. The whole world is your own. That is a sign of jnani. Ajnana has been lost. The whole world is your own. Whole world is your own self. So when that arises, then why do you bother? How to become a celebrity? Swami Vivekachudamani's speech. I asked him, Maharaj, what? How did you say how to become a celebrity? Oh, then I said at the last, you are already a celebrity. That celebrity you are talking of, thinking about, it is you only who have become that. There is no difference between you and Abraham Lincoln. You are Abraham Lincoln, you are our Clinton, you are this president, everything is all yourself that appears as many. So why you have to become? You have already become that. That is jnana. Then there is no ichcha to attain anything. Then such person have no desire to live in the world, no desire to eat, no desire to do good things. No. Those desires will be there. The binding desires will not be there. Desires that create tension, that create frustration, that makes us run after the things to attain something which really doesn't give what I seek, that will not be there, because that person knows there is nothing to gain from this world. World has no power to make me full. Why? Because I am already full. One who is already Purna, what else should be added to that? So that awareness comes. Nothing is there to gain to make me happy. I am already, what that says, that verse from the Gita, it says, one who is happy by the self, in the self. Yastu atma ratireva syat atma triptasya manava. Atmani eva cha santushta. He is satisfied with himself, within himself. Atmani eva cha santushta. Tasya karyam na vidyate. No work is there left for that person. One who is totally satisfied within himself, who is happy within himself, for that person no work is left. So that person will sit like a log of the wood? No. Karya means the pravritti, one which impels us to work, born of desire. But that person's work will be for the good of others. Nothing that will make him bound, him or her bound to the work. That if that work doesn't succeed, oh, why it happened that way? Then that person starts having all the suffering because of the unsuccessfulness of that work. That is called pravritti, and pravritti is samsara. Anichor visaya kimnu pravritte karana svataha. So ajnana hridaya granthi. For that person, hridaya granthir vinasa. What type of vinasa? Ashesata vinasa. Completely hridaya granthi gone. What is hridaya granthi? When ajnana is gone. What is Hridaya Granthi? Hridaya Granthi is delusion, not of the heart, misunderstanding, which creates this delusion, this misunderstanding, this ignorance. That is the Hridaya Granthi. That delusion, moha, is Hridaya Granthi. That is asesata gone. Moha is gone. That this is the moha that makes a sense that I seek this, I need this, and everywhere this need comes, and all the time complaint comes. Our need is not only material needs, need also comes in like words, like thoughts, like behavior. What I seek is that person should be very kind to me. That desire also is desire, and if some person is rude, I become very angry with that person. Why? Because I had desire to find that person very kind, polite, good. If I have no desire, so let people say good thing or bad thing, doesn't matter. Then the prayer, as we said, may we not accuse, demand or complain. It's such a Vedantic, high philosophic prayer that we do before having food as grace, that accusing, demanding and complaining. Always demanding something. You should give me good words. You should give me nice way to think. You should be always nice to me, kind to me. That is also desire. That is also not being able to accept the people, the variety as it is. God has created varieties. That is the nature of creation. And in the variety, there will be kind people and unkind people. There will be friendly people and non-friendly people. There will be kind words and harsh words. There will be sunny day and snowy day. Why we become so frustrated and demand only spring? We want spring, when this winter will go. Let winter be there as long as God wants. It's beautiful, nice snow fell today and all melted. Like that, what is there? We had snow for like 4 months, then we are not so worried to when it will go. But now little remains. God has a lot of stock, whatever is left in his stock, he's just putting it here. So it is all finishing. So demanding that, if we can't accept the thing as it is, then we get frustrated. And that is called Hridaya Granthi. Moha, I want that. If winter time not gone, then still we seek snow, we should stop. Then it is moha, and that becomes problem. But one whose Hridaya Ajnana is gone, his Hridaya Granthi gone. He has no ignorance or she has no ignorance, means she has no delusion. Moha is gone, has clear understanding, wisdom has arisen. For that person, Anichor Vishaya Kimnu. Then he becomes Anichu, no Ichha, no desire. This is to be understood. The jnani, the man of knowledge, the Jivan Mukta, does he have no desire? Shankaracharya was Jivan Mukta, so he was Anichu. Vivekananda was Jivan Mukta, Buddha was Jivan Mukta, Sri Ramakrishna was Jivan Mukta. Did they have desire or not? What is the difference between the desire of a jnani and desire of a ajnani? Our desire and their desire. Our desire is born of ignorance, where we try to gain the things, possess the things, we want to accumulate the things, we want certain type of behavior from the people. But for jnani, nothing is there. Whatever people behave doesn't matter. Swami Vivekananda was walking on the street and someone pulled his turban. Swami Vivekananda, what we would do if we were there, we'd just come to him, start fighting, anger, police office. What Swami Vivekananda did? He turned to him and says, what are you doing? And he said, oh, you know English. And that man ran away. Swami Vivekananda was never bothered with that. And what he said, what he saw in that person was the limitation of love. Limitation of acceptance. You only accept the people that look like him, people that speak like him, people like dress like him. Only he is able to accept that and has not gone broader. He had a sympathy for that person's smallness, and that person has not gone, had to expand, that has not expanded. So that was Swamiji's feeling for that person, pity for that person has to be more expanded in his acceptance. Instead of that, he is loving, he is kind, Swamiji says. But his kindness is, his love is limited love, only to the people of his color, of his dress, and of his language. But when he saw same his own language being spoken by Swami Vivekananda, he ran away. So he had no problem. That is what they act. They are not bothered by how people behave to them. And try to understand the root of the things. Behavior, people will behave according to their nature. You cannot make them behave good. And always in the world, there will be people whom we will like more, other we like less, because difference will be there. So if sometimes you feel, oh, this colleague is troubling a lot to me, or in this office, this colleague, if I change the office, it will be so much peaceful, all will be good. Go to next office, same problem. That person who was bothering, that person gets retired, then you find another person taking the same role. It will be always there. That is the nature of the world. We cannot have all smooth and gone. What we have to make smooth is our mind to accept the people as they are. All are made different by the will of God, whom we can call, explain as samskaras, their samskaras, and there we have to live, adjusting with all types of people. And all are fine, as Swami Vivekananda said, their love, their understanding is all limited. Maybe that person doesn't love me, doesn't mean that person doesn't have love in that heart. He or she might be loving extremely to his children, grandchildren, to some friend, his spouse. But to me somehow there is little misunderstanding, dislike, but that all happens. So you don't bother for that. So this such person, jnani, will have anicca for pravritti, for achieving things for himself or herself, but that person will do good to the world. Shankaracharya will roam throughout India, walk from one place to another place to another place, giving wonderful message of Vedanta, enlightening the lives of the people, writing the scriptures, all this, and then that. Who knows this world is just a dream. Just Maya. How much work he did. Buddha, who has realized Nirvana, attained Nirvana, how much he connected with the people. They were so much working, but pravritti was not there. There was no pravritti, not for himself. Buddha didn't work for himself. Sri Ramakrishna didn't do it for his name and fame. Someone said to Sri Ramakrishna, "Oh, one person is writing book on you." So Sri Ramakrishna says, "Oh, that person then will become famous, he will have some name." And one person had gone to Gajipur to Pavahari Baba, who was a very well-known saint of Vairagya. He was very tremendously Vairagyavan. And he said that, "Oh, Pavahari, in Pavahari Baba's cave," he used to live in the cave, "there is your photograph, I saw that." And Sri Ramakrishna said, "Oh, of this hole, of this cover, photograph of this cover," he said. Nothing that he wants to become famous, what to become famous, to whom to become famous. One who knows, who nothing is there other than own self. It is all Atman, that is all appearing as many. So where you want to become famous, where you want to become more recognized, where you want to become more rewarded, nothing is that world can give us. So that is the type of a jnani. So anichor visaya kimnu. So one who has no ichcha or desire for the things, pravritte kimnu pravritte karana sutavaya. How can there be pravritti for that person? There is no desire left for that person. So what happens in samsara is ajnana leads to incompleteness. I am separate, finite. Ajnana of our infinity makes us finite. Just ajnana makes us finite. Then that finitude comes, then for finitude comes, then I see many things and then desires come. That if I could get this, if I could have this, all this pravritti comes. When the desire comes to have something, do something, then comes pravritti, action. You start doing the thing. I have not graduated, okay? Then I have to be graduated. Though I have not graduated, I am less than graduate, this inadequacy, incompleteness, lack of fullness, so I should graduate, that will make me full. So what I do then? I start studying, that is pravritti. That's how the thing in the world, samsara, goes on. And pravritti itself is a samsara. Because then I study a lot, and the exam I give, and what happens? I perhaps graduate, but marks are not sufficient. Then I feel bad. So samsara brings that. And if marks are good and you become first, then so I am the first boy, then the bondage comes, ego comes, all this pravritti brings samsara to us. Samsara is bondage, samsara is ignorance, and that how it goes. So when one is free from ajnana, is free from delusion, and that makes him free from selfish desires, desires to attain something in the world, anicca, he becomes anicca, and that person is free from pravritti or the bondage of samsara. So what a wonderful state when one is free from all desires, all expectations, that person will not complain for anything. That person will not demand anything from anyone. I demand this, you should do this, he doesn't demand. And when this demand and complain and all this is gone, then what remains is peace and joy. From where does it come? Everything is gone. Because that is the nature of the self. That person goes closer to his or her own self. Be thyself. That's what they say. Be thyself. So we are not connected to ourselves. We get connected to so many things. In Honduras something is going on, India what Modi did. All we are all connected to India, Honduras and US. So many things we are get connected. But we are not connected to our own self. And wherever we are connected, mostly it is all disturbing thing. And get more involved in the disturbing thing. That is not good, that person is not doing well, why is that bad? A little some good thing if we connect and we like that is very fine, that's good. That will make us connect to ourselves. If we are positive thing comes, that will connect to ourselves. When we connect to our true self, as for example in prayer and meditation, that gives tremendous peace. And when we get connect to something that is non-self, then we become nonsense. That connecting to non-self is becoming activity which is nonsense activity. They say, in Bengali there is a nice saying, they say, Lankai Ravan Molo Behuda Kede Akul. That means, in Ravana died in Lanka and there was one, Behula was a person. So he started crying, in Bengal. So he started crying, oh, Ravana died, no connection with Ravana at all. He is not an Asura, he lives in somewhere in India, somewhere north in India, suppose in Calcutta, and Ravana is there, nothing there. But he started crying, oh, Ravana died. Not that he liked Ravana, not that he made Ravana, no connection. That often we do. Unconnected thing and become very disturbed. Something happened in some corner, one person told me, one devotee, Swamiji, what the days are happening? I said, what happened? Swamiji, did you hear the news in Honduras, in one house that thing happened? So where is Honduras? I don't know. So that person, I don't know, he has never been Honduras, nothing, no connection. Something happened in somebody's house in Honduras, a fire caught or something happened. So that person, I was so sorry, Mara, so tired, so worried that I couldn't sleep last night. What happened? Some house got gutted in Honduras. I said, what to do? Like that we become where there is no connection, but we connect there, which we need not connect. We should have feeling, no doubt. But if we connect to ourselves, then we find house gutted, then what to do? Then you find the positive means to help the person. Otherwise, you just do not sleep at night. And next day you come frustrated, then talk to the Swami about all your problems. Honduras, one house was getting in Honduras. So, connecting to our own self, that is done through meditation the best way. When we try and sit and calm and separate ourselves from the world, at least for some time, and try to connect our true self. So our true self we see in the Easter. When we say Easter, the chosen form of God, that is our own self in that form. Easter is our own self. So when we try to connect with the Easter, then we are with our own self. And if we could really effectively do that, there is a lot of peace and happiness, joy there. So meditation makes us connect ourselves, prayer does that, nice talks does that, finding goodness in others, that all connects to our own self. Whenever we find goodness, that is connecting to ourself, because the self is good. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram, it is all auspicious, it is all good and it is the truth. Whenever we find that, we immediately connect to this thing and we find happiness. So to this person, samsara is gone. Verse 4:24. Vasana nudayo bhogye vairagyasya tadavadihi. Aham bhavo daya bhavo bodhasya paramavadihi. Lina vritte ranutpattir mariyado paratestusa. Here, Shankaracharya describes beautifully in a poetic way the ultimate of a person of knowledge, a realized soul. How is his vairagya? What level is his anahankara, non-egotism, at what level? And at what level is his pravritti, uparati? How much he has given up his pravritti, samsara? So, what type of it happens? Vairagya, bodha and uparati, jnanam. So what type of vairagya, how much it has vairagya up to ultimate. Those are the treasure of a realized soul, vairagya. But vairagya is supposed to be of a person, of a novice also. Yes, he also or she also should not be attracted to the things of the world and give the right value to the things of the world, not give extra additional value added to the things of the world. But these are all, that person has to try to not to be attracted, still not matured enough, not purified enough, the things may catch. We often hear that, oh, that person was so good, he did this. So that he was not established in vairagya, or she was not established in vairagya. So that somehow from subconscious this attraction came again, and that attraction caught that person. So one who is really established in knowledge, steadfast wisdom, what Sri Krishna says. So what happens to him? Vasana nudayo bhogye. For him, bhogye vasana anudaya. When bhogya is the things of enjoyment, in that vasana anudaya, there is no rising of vasana, of desire to enjoy food, name and fame, whatever you say, there is no rising, no at all any desire to enjoy the things of the world. Objects of enjoyment is called bhogya. What is then bhoga is called bhogya. That makes us, gives the joy of bhoga is called bhogya. It begins from food, drink, anything. Appearance, cloth, anything is bhogya. Car, house, whatever we think is all bhogya. For a man of knowledge, there is no temptation from that. Not being tempted by the things of enjoyment, not at all. So that person may do lot of window shopping, but never that person will enter to buy the thing. What happens? We go for morning walk, we do window shopping, see the thing, and the malls are open and windows are all glass. You see, they are very clever. And what they do, and sometimes we walk and they find something very nice. Oh, this is good set, this is good cloth, I don't need. But when we see and have started liking to that, suppose you like, oh, it's beautiful. A subtle way that desire to possess that comes. And one day we'll find, yeah, that has got old, that color has faded, and one having another is nothing, it's not very expensive, only $150. So that will be okay. And you tend to buy that. And that buying started maybe after 1 month you'll buy. But that started when you have liked the thing and stopped and saw, yes, everything is good, it seems, and good company also, and it feature fits me, and this color I like. That just you had said, but I don't need. But that when not needing, not wanting, it becomes center, converts into your want, and you go inside one day and buy it, because vasana udaya happens to us. We are ajnani. For this person, there is no udaya of vasana, bhogya vasana. You don't want to enjoy and possess anything that will give enjoyment, totally satisfied. Or as in the case of Sri Ramakrishna. Sometimes, some small, he at the very first level, at the level when we stood and said, oh, it looks good, that level, little had arisen. He was so clear of the thing. So somehow he felt that if gold-threaded shawl. Sometime it might have come. How does it feel like having that? So it came and he asked Mathur Babu, I feel like having that, can you make me? And Mathur Babu, what happens? We thought we get that desire and try to negate that. We think, oh, how, why will he give? It is so much expensive. What will people say? I will use that money in otherwise. But that desire to possess and use that remains. And I try to negate it with the thought. But that unless that desire is gone, it will make me buy when the opportunity comes. Sri Ramakrishna that came, desire, little faint desire came, said to Mathur Babu, what does it happen that way? And Mathur Babu gave that, he overput this and said, oh mind, this is called wearing of gold threaded shawl. Next moment, within few seconds, he put it out, put on the ground and trampled with the feet and said, nothing gone, all desire left. Sometimes he had desire to eat onion. What is happened to onion? So he brought half-cut onion, put in the mouth, and he said, I put from left to right and right to left, and then threw it away. All desires to eat, onion gone. So desires leave totally, then there is no udaya of bhogya vasana. There is no desire to enjoy anything that often people say it is very great thing. That happened to our Kathopanishad, Nachiketa, he went to Yama. To Yama he said, is there life after death? Is Atma eternal? Or everything finishes with the death of the body? Is there something called Atma? So Yama said, this is a very tough question. You are a small boy. How do you ask this question? Even gods do not know the secret about the Atma. How it is, where it is or not. Oh, don't ask, please don't ask this question. Rather, I will give you very long life and lot of money and land as much as you like. And to add it to that, you see, in the heaven, in this place, there are many dancers, damsels, chariots, like our Ferrari and all those cars. That heavenly chariots. And take this and live as long as you like. That's what it is. As long as you like, you live. Yama, no power. He said, give freedom, open check. And what Nachiketa says, I don't want anything of these. You said to me, as long as I like, I can live, but there will be end of that. One day that will be dead. And you say, enjoy these things of the heavenly enjoyment, bhogya. But how much man can enjoy? Senses are very limited, and their power to enjoy is limited. They become tired. And this all thing becomes, it dies next day, Shobhava Martasya. Next day it doesn't remain. And you ask me to take this, you enjoy your thing, he says. Tavaiva Vaha Tava Nitya Gite. Your dance and music, you enjoy. Tell me the truth about the Atman. That is called Vairagya. What a tremendous Vairagya. Nothing of the world can give me this. I want to know this. The seeking of knowledge. And he says, you say it is difficult for anyone to know, have this knowledge. Even the gods do not know. So this means that is most valuable. And when I have met the teacher like you, who can grant, I have to gain and know from you the truth about the Atman. And Yama was tasting the Vairagya of Nachiketa. If he had no full Vairagya, he couldn't understand, he could not hold, even he knows about the Atman, he will forget. Vairagya attracts, this Maya attracts. One has to be immune to the attractive power of Maya to realize the truth. Otherwise, this little you realize and the Maya attracts. Oh, he is such a jnani, he is a wonderful thing he speaks, wonderful he does, and next day you find he has fallen. There is some scam, this, that, you all find this way. So Nachiketa was being tested by Yama whether he can hold the knowledge of self or not. That's why he offered those all heavenly bhogya vishayavastu. He said, tavai vavaha tava nitya gite. Your songs and dancers and singers be you, with you. Give me the knowledge of the self. And Nachiketa, then Yama teaches. So bhogya vasana anudaya. There is no udaya of, or the rising of desire to enjoy the things. Other thing is, that is tadavadi, up till that is the highest. When things are there of enjoyment, but nothing is there to desire, enjoy that. When you don't do things, when you are good, when you are alone, then you know that you are good. I should not eat sweet, okay? But when people are there, I say, oh, I'm diabetic, I don't eat. But when nobody is there, then you open the fridge and you take one sweet. So that vasana is not gone for the enjoyment. So that is not the case. When nobody is there, still you don't eat that sweet. You are then established. That often it happens. Inside there are so many levels of our wishes, this mind. So bhogya vasana, there doesn't arise at all to desire to enjoy anything, any food like that, which is harmful, which is not good. You just eat the things, you may enjoy. Another thing we have to understand, does a realized soul enjoy a cup of coffee? Or he doesn't want anything to eat, only drinking water. If a realized soul or a very famous sadhu, he wants a cup of coffee in the morning, can you give me that particular brand, Starbucks coffee? Will we think he's still affected by the desire? He has the desire, he's still bound. Bhogye anudaya has not come. Bhogye vasana anudaya has not come. No, not that. That sadhu or that realized soul may ask for a cup of Starbucks coffee. But if he doesn't get, it will have no effect on that. If he wants Starbucks and you bring Tim Hortons, he will not become sad and throw away, why did you bring, I don't drink this. He will not say that. For him it is same thing. If you bring what you had said, what you want, Swami, and he said, bring me Starbucks coffee. So if Starbucks is not there, Tim Hortons is also fine. If Tim Hortons is there, I couldn't find, I forgot. Oh, that's fine, sit down. No effect of anything. So that shows that there is no desire left, was there. There is no binding. Desires often bind us. When there are some wishes which really don't bind, these are not strong wishes, not binding wishes, then there is no problem. When there are very strong desires, problem happens in life and also at the time of death. Maybe at the time of death that will come, oh, life went, I couldn't have that. At the time of death, when you are thinking of God and next life, then you'll think, what happened, I didn't have that. That, like that story goes, one person was at the deathbed and he says, where is my wife, come. I said, I am here, and he says, where is Ramesh? Ramesh was his son. I am also here, father. Then he says, where is Lalita? Lalita was his daughter. I am also here, dad. So they think that they will be happy. You all are here, why this fan is on in your another room? So fan was moving and that person is worried for the fan, and that's the last breath he's going to take. So all desires, that things are, my children will all misuse, and what will happen, and you are going, you are going to die. So still so much desire, what will happen to this person? You will be born again back and in this house, and maybe a darwan, to protect and switch off all the time when everybody is gone. If you have desire, karma says that, you will be born again. And there is a story that some is born again as a dog in the house to protect and take care, like that. So when the time comes to die, you, this is the freedom, you go away, move on. Move on. And otherwise you will be bound. This life is short and it's only in this world. It's not forever, it happens that way. We have to move on. And what about the ego? Aham bhava udaya abhava bodhasya paramavadi. That is the bodha, that is the awareness. That is the his awareness about the ego is being. Ego is not there, binding ego is not. Aham bhava, ego, aham bhava is udaya abhava. There is no rise of aham, nothing, nowhere, that oh, I, sometimes no, this ego is also plays, you know, this mind and ego, these are not always same. Sometimes they are very strong and sometimes very, they are moderate for us also. Sometimes if say, when someone says something, you don't become angry. The same thing again said in another moment when your mind was disturbed, you become very angry. That time this aham bhava is at the highest, ego is very strongly risen. And that affects you. Sometimes you, in our level also, in our mental level, when you are agyani, then also ego is sublimated, ego has a lower level, and ego doesn't hurt much. And it happens from people to people. When our own people whom we love a lot, our grandson comes and he says something or pulls you or something or breaks something, we don't become angry. But someone else does whom we do not know, we become angry, we flare up. Why that person has to do? So our level of minus is less, our level of love for that person is less because we don't have the knowledge of the oneness of the self. That person is different. This is my grandson, so whatever he does is right. That person is different, why he should disturb me in that way? That our ego rises, that time we become angry and furious. So for this person, aham bhava udaya abhava. What a poetic language, aham bhavo dayo bhava. That means egolessness. Aham bhavo dayo bhava means aham bhava udaya abhava. Abhava of what? Lack of what? Aham bhava udaya, rising of aham bhava, ego-ness, I-ness. I-ness is not rising to that person. That is another sign of bodha. Bodha goes up to that level. Never the ego is there. He's free from ego. Sri Ramakrishna was asked, oh, how much ego you find in me? Is there any ego? He asked Yam. And Yam says, you have kept a little ego too for the good of the world. Sri Ramakrishna says, no. I have not kept. It's mother who has kept ego in me. Not even he wants to keep. He is totally surrendered, 100% absolute surrender to the will of God. And God makes Sri Ramakrishna move, and that song says, whatever you make me speak, I speak. Whatever you make me walk, I walk. Like that. Whatever you are the Ichchamoyi Tara Tumi. You are the you are the full of your own will. So your will you fulfill through me. That's what it is. And vritti, lina vritti anutpatti maryado paratastusa. Lina vritti means his vritti is lina. Lina means kshina. This is gone. Vritti nasaha. That person's vritti is gone. Pravritti is gone. The action for selfish work is gone. Nothing he will work for himself or herself, nothing to achieve. So vritti totally gone, ego is totally gone, and his desire to enjoy is totally gone. That person is totally established in the self. So pravritti is that. So that person is remains in maryada, is the ultimate uparati or jnana nistha of that person. Absolute egolessness, absolute freedom from the desire for the enjoyment, and absolute freedom from the selfish action, that I need to do it for myself, is not there. So what happens to that person when that he doesn't do anything or she doesn't do anything for himself? Sri Krishna says, one who doesn't work anything for himself or herself and is totally dependent on me, I will take care of that person. Then thing comes. To such persons all the help comes. The society helps, God helps too through so many people. So the thing is, to be established in that is difficult. And for that, the knowledge of the self. If there is a jnana is done, all this will automatically come. Ajnana timirandhasa jnananjana shalakaya chakshurinmilitamena tasmai sri gurave namaha. So what guru does is, I was in dark in ajnana. The dark ajnana is thinking myself separate from the whole. And then fearful always worried, always in anxiety, I was that. And what Guru did? Jnananjana Shalakya. With the stick of knowledge, he opened my eyes. And now I am able to see what I am, that I belong to everyone. Everyone is my own. And then that Guru I bow down, by whose grace I could understand my true self. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Sri Ram Krishna Arpanamastu Jananim Saradam Devim Ram Krishna Jagat Gurum Pad Padme Tayo Sritva Pranamami Muhu